Congressman, it's clear the president's son, Hunter, will be involved in any potential impeachment inquiry in some shape or form. Recently, you urged Oversight Committee Chairman James Comer, the Republican, to investigate Donald Trump's son-in-law, Jared Kushner, for his foreign business dealings, especially with the Saudis. Why didn't Democrats do more to investigate Kushner when you were in the majority? The Republicans have succeeded in turning Hunter into a boogeyman, even though Hunter never worked a day in the White House. Yet Jared, who did, is doing just fine.
MSNBC host Mehdi Hasan grilled House Oversight Committee ranking member Jamie Raskin for basically slow walking investigations into Jared Kushner's deals with Saudi Arabia. Now, rather than answer the question directly, Raskin kind of deflected by recounting the allegations themselves. Take a quick look at that.
Well, remember, Jared's essential crime against the Constitution and the Republic came right after the Trump administration ended. It was, I think, the day after it ended that he created the corporation, which he proceeded to endow with $2 billion from the homicidal crown prince of Saudi Arabia and then other sovereign wealth funds from Gulf monarchs. So all of this is an ongoing story right now in the Biden administration. And of course, the Republicans are in control of the House just narrowly by four votes. But even Chairman Comer has conceded that Jared Kushner crossed an ethical line. And so all we're saying is, look, Jared Kushner was actually working in the White House. He was in the administration. Hunter Biden was never in the Biden administration.
I get that. Administration. I'm just wondering why you didn't do this earlier.
And Mehdi Hasan is correct in asking that question because it's been, what, 2.5 years? Yep. Ever since this whole situation, suspicious issue came up. So for context, let's give you guys a refresher on this. So a few weeks ago, Congressman Jamie Raskin requested that the House Oversight Committee Chair James Comer subpoena Kushner for more information on his dealings with the Saudis. In fact, he's saying so while talking to Jake Tapper. While talking to Jake Tapper, James Comer even admitted that there were some ethical concerns in regard to Jared Kushner's dealings with the Saudis. So as soon as the Trump administration was over, he forms this private equity firm and takes this massive amount of money from the Saudis. I'm gonna give you more details on that in just a moment. But look, if you happen to be more conservative and you're like, I'm watching a progressive show, they're probably lying because we're talking about Republicans here. Don't take it from me, take it from James Comer, a Republican lawmaker.
Jared Kushner, 6 months after he leaves the White House, gets $2 billion from the Saudi sovereign wealth fund when Donald Trump had put him in a position to be in the Middle East. What was Jared Kushner doing in the Middle East?
Again, sir, it all stinks to me. It all stinks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, look, and I've been vocal that I think that what Kushner did crossed the line of ethics. But what Christie said, it happened after he left office. Still no excuse, Jake, but it happened after he left office.
Yes, it happened after he left office, but also he forged all sorts of relationships in his role in the White House. And what he specifically did is he formed that private equity firm called Affinity Partners just after leaving the White House. The Saudi government provided huge investments to the firm along with other Gulf nations. Kushner reportedly took $2 billion from a sovereign wealth fund chaired by Saudi Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman, the same individual that Donald Trump tried to provide cover for after he ordered the assassination and dismemberment of Washington Post journalist and US resident Jamal Khashoggi. During the Trump administration, Kushner had been tasked with managing Middle East policy and worked closely with Mohammed bin Salman. And also a report from The Intercept during the Trump years found that MBS bragged about having Kushner in his pocket. Kushner was also deeply involved in a $110 billion weapons sale to Saudi Arabia back in 2017. I recall when right wingers like Alex Jones pretended to be concerned about Saudi Arabia and tried to blame Democrats for their close ties with Saudi Arabia. Really interesting that he had nothing to say about that when the Trump administration was very much enmeshed in Saudi business deals.
No, it's over, right wingers. Your favorite country is now Saudi Arabia. So Donald Trump and Jared Kushner are both making millions upon millions of dollars from Saudi Arabia. They gave every favor in the world. They let him dismember a journalist that worked for the Washington Post. The allegations from The Intercept are that Jared Kushner gave our sources inside Saudi Arabia to Mohammed bin Salman, and one of them was tortured to death. If a Democrat had done that, you're talking about Hunter Biden's art. If Hunter Biden had turned over sources that he got from his dad and they got tortured to death by Muslim fundamentalists, tell me that you wouldn't be seeing red. Tell me that you wouldn't be the most irate people on planet Earth. But when your beloved Donald Trump does the corruption and his beloved son-in-law, and they take $2 billion off the Saudis, all of a sudden you're perfectly okay with it. Oh, the Saudis, they have the same exact moral code as ISIS. But all of a sudden you guys love the Saudis. I mean, come on. Have you no shame at all? Let alone all the golf tournaments, all of a sudden the Saudis get live. They buy the PGA and they direct all the golf tournaments to Donald Trump's properties. And James Comer is so disingenuous. He's like, Hunter Biden's $5 million for something, something, something. I'm so mad about $2 billion for Jared Kushner. It was after office. He got the payment after office for things he did while he was in office.
Exactly. In fact, some more suspicious stuff happening with this whole deal with the Saudis. So there's even a panel that screens investments for the Saudi Sovereign Wealth Fund. They had concerns over Kushner and his firm. They had concerns with the $2 billion from the Sovereign Wealth Fund being funneled over to Kushner's brand new private equity firm. So in 2022, the New York Times looked at the panel's objections seriously, and they looked at previously undisclosed documents from the panel's meeting, which took place on June 30th of 2021. Here's where they found some issues. Here are their concerns. The inexperience of the affinity fund management, the possibility that the kingdom would be responsible for the bulk of the investment and risk, due diligence on the fledgling firm's operations that found them unsatisfactory in all aspects, a proposed asset management fee that seems excessive, public relations risks from Mr. Kushner's prior role as a senior advisor to his father-in-law, former President Donald J. Trump. But the Saudi Crown Prince, Mohammed bin Salman, overruled the panel, and the Saudi fund invested twice as much with Kushner compared to former Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin, even though Mnuchin had a successful investment record as a Wall Street goon and all of that. Now, Mnuchin was also a part of Trump's cabinet, as you all know, from 2017 to 2021. The debate within the Saudi fund over investing in Kushner's firm was in clear contrast to the easy approval of Mnuchin's proposal. Mnuchin's fund focused on cybersecurity, financial technology, and entertainment, aligning with Saudi priorities, while Kushner's firm lacked a clear focus.
Yeah. So, guys, the national security community was outraged by Jared Kushner at some point in the Trump administration. You might remember that story. And they pulled his clearance. They said he is not to get the presidential daily briefings anymore, even though he was running our foreign policy in a lot of ways, and especially in the Middle East. The Intercept's reporting seems to indicate that they pulled it because Kushner gave over the names of our guys inside Saudi Arabia. And those are the ones that MBS arrested, stole from, tortured, and one of them was killed. So if they prove that, and someone should try very hard, I'm not saying try to prove something that didn't happen, but if there's any chance that that happened, Jared Kushner should spend the rest of his life in jail. So, and this is worse than Hunter Biden, and not just because of the magnitude of the money, billions of dollars, right? And not because of the magnitude of the potential crime, which is might have literally gotten people killed, right? But also think about how outrageous it is. So everybody knows that Hunter Biden is not an expert on Ukrainian gas and modern art at the same time. He's running every two-bit scam there is in the country, which makes him more similar to Donald Trump than it does to Joe Biden. But we already talked endlessly about the no connection to Joe Biden as far, there's been no evidence of that, right? But guys, it's As absurd as Hunter's claims to expertise are, Jared's is worse. Because not only, like you said, well, he's run investments before and he's done real estate investments. That's right. And he has potentially the worst record in American history. He bought what is considered to be the worst real estate investment we have ever had in this country. 666 Fifth Avenue, right before the 2008 crash, nearly bankrupted his entire family, who was loaded. And that he is one of the dumbest investors in the world right now. And they give that guy $2 billion. This stuff is proven. This is not conjecture. You can look up 66 Fifth Avenue and how disastrous it was. No sane investor in their right mind would give a nickel to Jared Kushner, let alone $2 billion, which he makes $25 million a year from, even if he loses all the money. $25 million at a bare minimum per year. It makes all of Hunter Biden's scams look like child's play. Kushner looks at him and goes, amateur. And in your case, you didn't even get dad to do what you said.
Right.
I got Trump to do everything I wanted.
Okay. Which is why the investigation is an important one. And which is why I agree with Mehdi Hasan's line of questioning here. Why did it take Jamie Raskin so long to call on the House Oversight Committee Chair, James Comer, to open an investigation into Jared Kushner? In fact, final video on that exchange, let's watch.
You know, I think we've been doing everything we can to try to catch up with what we know. And what we're trying to find out is exactly what did Saudi Arabia get out of this arrangement and what is the nature of all the money that's been pouring in. Now, we know that they covered up the assassination of Jamal Khashoggi, the drawing and quartering by the paid assassins. Yes. Who were sent by the crown prince.
Yes.
We know that they were aligned with Saudi Arabia in the Yemen war, and they went there first. You know, that was the first foreign trip that Donald Trump took. So they got a lot out of it. And we were talking about all of that at the time.
Did.
But look, we're going to do a complete report on foreign government emoluments that were pocketed by Donald Trump. And we're still trying to torture out the information, which we've never gotten.
Torture out, interesting phrase. Yeah. In this context. But you know, I do think that this is one of the investigations that makes a lot of sense. So hopefully they move forward with that. We'll see where it goes.
Okay, I want to give a word here to one of our members. Cenk's left tricep of fury wrote in, as much as I respect Raskin, that's a legit question and he needs to answer that.
Agreed.
So good catch, by the way, tyt.com/join to become a member and be part of the show. Raskin never answered the question. And the question isn't, why didn't you do something 6 months ago or 4 months ago when the Republicans were already in charge? The real question is, why didn't you do anything when you were in charge for the first 2 years of the Biden term? Now, look, but important context here. Jamie Raskin is not the bad guy. Jamie Raskin is now bringing up the Jared Kushner issue when no other Democrat will. Why they wouldn't bring that up is insanity. It's totally inexplicable. So thank you, Jamie Raskin, for bringing it up. And Jamie Raskin is about at least twice as aggressive as the average Democrat. The problem is, even the most aggressive guys like Jamie Raskin, who are now bringing it up as an issue, are still 2,000 times less aggressive than the average Republican. Like, the Republicans will take the molehill and make 2,000 mountains out of it. And the Democrats will take a giant, they'll take Mount Everest and go, molehill? Come on, guys, get in the goddamn game. Mehdi Hasan, great line of questioning, but don't blame Jamie Raskin. He's at least trying, as opposed to all the other Democrats.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.